Hey, what up, Northside? It's your boy DeAndre Harvey.
And I'm Drew, and your Grizzly News starts right now.
1, 2, 3, My baby don't mess around because she loves me so, and this I know for sure. But does she really want to, but can't stand to see me walk out the door. Don't try to fight the feeling because the thought alone is killing me right now.
I'm walking you're backwards, you're walking way. This way. You're what supposed you to be looking about? Where you're going.
Dude.
Don't fight or record fights, or there will be consequences.
Man, we've been here for like 15 minutes,
y'all. I know, bro.
Man, where's Julian?
Be right here somewhere.
I swear he caught me off guard last time, man. I'm dude, ready.
He gonna get his, bro.
He's not coming, John.
Let's get him.
Bro, we gonna keep coming.
Took not a doubt, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, there he is right now.
Now, the moral of the story is, don't fight. Don't fight here. Don't fight anywhere else. But especially, do not fight at school. It's just not worth it.
Let's give a big congratulations to the boys' soccer team for winning the Fort Smith Invitation.
We also want to take this time to congratulate Haley Dingman. She was a top 3 finalist in Project Prevent's Big Pitch Film Festival.
We're not done. Deck is doing big things around the state as well. They won big last week at the Deck competition. Check out the screen and congratulate these students when you see them. In other Grizzly news, on Monday, tryouts will begin for the 2017-2018 Cheer Squad. Good luck to all students trying out.
Also, get your activity ready because cheer tryouts are coming up after spring break.
Before we move on, take a look at this PSA on how to stay out of trouble.
Oh, what's up, please? What's up, guys? Vic. And today I'm going to be teaching you how to stay out of trouble.
What are you doing? Get out of my class!
Oh. It's whatever.
Alright, so we're on page 60 of 1984. Hang on. You gotta get to work, okay? Alright. Okay. So, we're on page 60 of 1984.
If you haven't got your yearbooks yet, there's still time. Stop by Miss Haslin's room. That's 106, remember. Yearbooks are $65, and you can put a $20 down payment on it to place your order.
Do you ever forget where to go during huddle? Here's a PSA on how to remember and exactly what should be happening during huddle.
For the past few months, Northside students have been on huddle schedule. Huddle is an activity aimed helping those who need an extra boost with their grades. Assistant Principal Tony Jones says that there is only a handful of students who don't do anything constructive during huddle.
Even though there are students who are in the cafeteria, how I like to look at that is, number one, there are some students in the cafeteria who are taking advantage of it and doing homework and getting extra study time or working with a friend. And there are other students who, in my opinion, have earned the time to not do anything during huddle because all of their coursework and grades are where they need to be.
Mr. Jones says that about two-thirds of students who take advantage of huddle academically or attend clubs that they are a part of. He wishes that the other third of the students would see that huddle is meant to help them and not to just sit around and talk, an idea he tries to implement by being visible in those classes.
I try to go around and not only sit in some of the classrooms to see what's going on, but talk to students and try to encourage them that this extra 35 minutes is for you to be more part of your school from a academic standpoint or from attending any kind of club or organization. I just wish all the students would take advantage of it.
Mr. Jones says that they do plan to continue huddle next year if approved by the Department of Education.
And what we don't want to do is ruin huddle for everybody else because only a few students aren't doing what they're supposed to do.
Oh, hey, Luis.
What's up, bro?
It's good. So what are you going to huddle?
Hey, I need for you to go to huddle. Oh man, I gotta go to English.
Dang.
All right, man. I'm here.
All right, everybody. Hey man, we need everybody to show up 8:30, man. 8:30 to get on the bus. We're gonna have a spirit bus. We're gonna invite all our friends to get on there, have a good time, crack jokes, listen to music, just enjoy ourselves, and then go up to Hot Springs and cheer on the Grizzlies. Let them know that we're there for them and we need them to win. So let's go Grizzlies.
Okay, we have a special edition of 90 Second Sports with John Cat Savage. Let's get it.
Let's go, John.
Just left out Dubai with all my folk. Open water, my location is remote. Shout out Yachty, but this ain't a little boat. This some shit I wrote about when I was broke. See the power of the mind is not a joke. Man, I said that I would do it and I did. Used to get leftovers out the fridge.
Welcome back to 90 Seconds in Sports. I'm John Katsavis, obviously. Today I'm in the field house again. In a little sports. Wednesday night, soccer team got the dub 1-0. Against Rogers. Last Friday, the baseball team came back in the ninth inning from down 7 runs to beat Alma. So congrats on that, guys. I'm really proud of you. But the real sport we got to talk about this week is basketball. Girls, heck of a job on the season. You guys were awesome. We had a great time watching y'all, and congrats. Good job. So at this time, I'm going to have Mr. Jackson Forsey step in. He's the starting power forward for the Northside Grizzlies. Jackson, how are you doing this week? I know there's a lot of pressure, a lot of tension around this week, so what are your thoughts on Saturday's game?
We just have to come together and play like we did in the state tournament, same way.
After all the hype all season around you guys and all the talk about what kind of postseason you guys would have, and how nice is it to be in the state championship game with all the talk and the hype about it the whole season?
It feels good to live up to the hype. We're very excited to have a chance to win it all.
Yeah, we're very excited for you guys here, the school, the whole community. We're taking a couple buses down Saturday. It's going to be a great game. It's 12:45, by the way, in Hot Springs. So we'll get you more on the location on that. But for right now, thank you, Jackson. We'll be excited to see you Saturday. So go Bears.
And just a reminder, if you aren't riding the bus, the game will be played at Bank of the Ozarks Arena. All right, Grizzlies, that's the end of this newscast. We'll catch y'all later.